Hello everyone, this is Dr. Ashish Onmai and today I am presenting a small video on how to use the software called as Spincastomatic. Now the reason behind making this video is because of this pandemic our schools and colleges are closed down and we are not able to carry out our regular teaching learning activities. And now there is a need that we post the e-learning resources so that the teaching learning process is not stopped completely and it continues. And the students can also learn while they are at home. And we will be also delivering the lecture content to the student. So many people are trying various things. Okay, some people are using mobile phones and then they are trying to record the videos. But normally when you do that kind of stuff, there is a lot of issue regarding the clarity of what you record, the audio, etc. So instead of that, normally one can use some easy ways to do the recording. And one of them is a screen recording mechanism where you have your presentation with you and you record your screen along with a audio. That means you actually speak about what you want to present along with your presentation and that is what is recorded. Now this is one way to do it. Of course there are many other ways to do this thing. So I am actually demonstrating how to record the screen with the audio. Okay, so stay tuned to this video. Okay, and I will step by step explain you the process how to do it. There are many softwares available in the market which allows you to record the screen. Some of them you can see on the screen over here. I have listed the free softwares. Of course there are some proprietary software is also available which we can use. So there is a software that is Spincastomatic, EZVID, iScream screen recorder, or you have something called as ShareX, Flashback Express, and actually there are many more. If you search on the net, you will get a whole lot of list of these kind of software. So what I have used out of that, I find the Spincastomatic and EZVID are more easy to use and more kind of a simple software, and that's why I'm demonstrating one of them over here. The Spincastomatic is the simplest of all these softwares. Of course there are certain limitations when you use the free version. If you have possible you can of course then go for the proprietary version of it, which offers lot of other stuff. Okay, so let's start first how to download the software first and then I will explain you how to use it. To download the software you will open any browser. I am using Google Chrome over here. So I will search for Spincastomatic. And when you search for it, there will be various options you will get. The first link you will get is Spincast-O-Matic, screen recorder and video, and the site address is screencast-o-matic.com. So this is the site we are looking for. So click on it. You will get a website which will appear something like this. On the first window itself, you will get a button over here which says start recording for free. So if you want to do the process online, you can click on this button and you can start recording your screen. We'll prefer to download the software. So we will scroll down. Okay. And when you scroll down, you will get something like I need to record my screen, and below that you will get download free screen recorder. So click on this. Okay. It says again launch free recorder. So this is again an online a recorder. We don't want that. We want the offline one. So we would download it. So I will go all the way down this page. Okay, go all the way down and need to work offline. You will get something like this. Okay, and here you will get download screen recorder. Okay, so this is the thing that we want. So click on this. Okay, and it will ask you to download the exe file, install Screencast-O-Matic 2.0 version. So download this version, install it, and you are ready to record your screen. Once you have installed the software, you will get an icon like this on your screen. So if you double click on this, it will open up your Screencast-O-Matic software. Okay, so this is the launch window you will see, and there is something called as launch free recorder. So if you click on this, it will open up your screen recorder. Now there are three types of captures that you can do. You can do a screen capture, you can do a webcam capture, or you can do both screen as well as webcam capture. So let's see one by one. So when you go for screen, okay, you can capture the screen that you want. Now if you see the settings over here, so you can hide and unhide the settings using this setting button over here. So you have selected screen. So maximum time of recording is 15 minutes. Okay, for free version that you use, the time is restricted to 15 minutes only. If you want more than that, then you will have to do the video in parts. The size over here is 480p. So you can see a screen over here. Okay, a box, that is what the screen it is capturing. Of course, you can move this box wherever you want. Okay, so you can move the box. So if you place it over here, that is the portion it will capture. If I move it over here, this is the portion it will capture. Okay, I can even have the size as 720p, which will be a bigger size. Or if you are switching between the windows, you can select the active window, or you can go for a full screen. So when you say full screen, it will capture your entire screen. So normally I prefer the full screen option because we are doing a presentation. So whenever the presentation we display it in the presentation mode, it is always full screen. So we can use this full screen mode to capture it. You can see narration over here, and as you speak, you can see some green bars, okay, which become highlighted. So that means your mic is actually working properly. Okay, this software will automatically detect the microphone or the mic that you are connected to your PC or the laptop. So normally you don't have to worry about it. And there is one more option called as computer audio, and this is not available in the free version, so I will not discuss about it for the time. Okay, so once you have set say screen, okay, what you do, you just need to do is start the recording. Okay, so when you say record, it will give you a kind countdown over here, and your recording has started. Actually, when you start, actually, let me just pause it over here. Yeah, and again it will come. So whatever you have recorded, it has recorded for almost 6 seconds over here. Okay, what it has recorded, if you want to see, you can click on this arrow like button which says preview what you recorded. Okay, so it will show you the preview of it, right? For the timing, I'm just going to delete it because I don't want that recorded, whatever I have recorded. So I will say delete everything and start over again. It will ask you, yes, really want to start over or not? So I will say yes. Okay, normally before you actually start, what you can do is whatever presentation you have, you are going to use, okay, you use or start that and do it in the full screen mode. So now it is a full screen that is available over here, and then you press your record button. Okay, of course we can trim the video from the start, and then I will demonstrate that also. Okay, so I have done it now full screen mode, and then I will say record, and after I press, after the countdown start, this screen is what is going to appear first, and then I will record slide by slide what I want to say. So let's start. Hello everyone, this is Dr. Ashish Unmai demonstrating you how to use Screencast-O-Matic. Go to the next slide. This is the free recording software list. And now when you do this recording, actually whenever you move your pointer, actually that pointer will get highlighted when you see your recorded video. Okay, so go slide by slide and record the audio. Now before you actually start, ensure that the PPT is ready in all aspects, and also your script, keep your script ready, what you want to say for each slide, and if possible do a rehearsal so that when you record you are you will be absolutely correct in the recording process. Now why we are doing this? Okay, we are using a free version. Okay, so in this free version there is no edit option available, so if you do any mistakes or if by chance if there are any disturbances, you will have to flush that recording and you will have to start again. That's why when you record, ensure that your script is ready, there are no disturbances, and whatever you are planning should fit in 15 minutes because that is the maximum duration possible. And remember one thing, okay, you can't change the mode while you are capturing the recording. Okay, so we have, let's say, finished our recording. So I will say, I will click on that red button which says pause. Okay, and I will simply now say, of course you can click on this. Okay, so it shows you the whatever we have done, or you can say done, and it then opens your window which allows you to either edit the video or save and upload. Of course the edit option is not available in free version, it is only in the paid version. So we'll go for save and upload. Okay, now again if you want you can preview your video. Okay, I'm just going for, now you can see over here the pointer is captured. Okay, whenever you are not moving the pointer, it is not going to highlight it. Whenever the pointer moves, it will get highlighted. Okay, so I observe my video, I am happy with it. Sometimes it happens that, let's say you don't start with the full screen mode. Okay, there are some unnecessary things that are at the start. So what you can do is you can use this trim option available. Okay, so let me just click it. So there is a trim option available over here. So it allows you to change the start of the video. So if I, let's say, move ahead, and now if I see my video actually started from this. Okay, if I roll it back, my video will start from the, sorry. Okay, similarly you can trim your end if you want. Okay, once you are done, you will say save video file. Of course you can publish it directly on the YouTube also, but normally I prefer it to first save it on my laptop or the PC and then upload it on my YouTube channel. Okay, so when you say save video file, okay, it will ask you which type of file you want to save, whether you want a MP4, AVI or FLV file. You can give the name of the recording, where you want to save it. So you can browse through the folder. Okay, normally it will show you the current folder, or you can browse through the folder. Okay, so I'm opening the folder selection box, and you can set the path that you want. So I already set it to a folder called a screencast in my some folders over here. So I will say OK, and I can give the name. So I will say demo 1, and I will say publish. So now you can see that the screencast software is now publishing that video, and this video will get saved in the folder that you have chosen. Say done. Okay, so if you go to that folder now, okay, you can see a video over here which says demo1.mp4. So this is the file. If you double click on this, you can see the video that you have recorded. So our video is ready, so we can upload this on the YouTube channel or Drive and then share it with our students. So far we have done some basic things. That means we have installed the software and we have made a simple video. Let's say we have a PowerPoint presentation and we added audio to it and we recorded a screencasted video. Now, apart from just doing that kind of video, you can also even demonstrate various things, like what I'm giving you a demonstration currently. So I'm here demonstrating you to how to use that particular software. Okay, so if you want to demonstrate also, you can use this particular software. So let me quickly show you how to use it for demonstrating it. It is not necessary that you always have to have a PowerPoint presentation to make a video. Okay, we can even use some PDF files. Let's say I have an ebook and I want to teach from that ebook. So I can even use that ebook. Or let's say I want to demonstrate something. There is an experiment which I'm conducting and I want to demonstrate that. So for that purpose also, I can use this particular software. So let's say I have launched my software over here. I will go for launch free recorder. Okay, I will use start with the standard size. Okay, I'm in the screen capturing mode and I will just move this. Let me keep it over here. Okay, and I will open my ebook. Let's say I have a PDF file of an ebook and I want to use this. So for this, I will adjust my window, what part I want to capture. Now let's see, this is the portion, but I don't want the last line. So what I will do is I will keep it over here and I will readjust my size over here. Okay, so this is the first part I will capture. So I will start my recording. So my countdown will begin. After this, whatever is this red box inside that, the screen will be captured. I will talk about that particular portion of my screen and then I will say pause. Now I scroll down. And then I try to fit the screen for the portion that I want to capture next. So this is the next part what I want to capture. Okay, let me just adjust the size a bit. Yeah. Okay, and then I will say record again. And I will record the audio for this particular part. Once I've finished, I will again pause it. So now if you see, when I pause, I also get some breathing time, okay, and to recollect the ideas or flip the pages of the script, etc. Okay, so if you have written a script, then what I will suggest you is to write a script one per page. Okay, so now let's say I want to show this particular portion. So again, I will click on the screen. Okay, yes, screen, fine. So I will say record. Okay, so again, I will talk about this part. Fine. Now I've done with it. So once I've say done, I will save this video. So I will say save. Now if you see the video now, you will see that only that particular whatever is the red box inside that, I will just click capture. I will talk about that. So here you have seen that actually when I've done, okay, let me just trim some last part over here, and I will say save audio file, video file. I will save, give some name. So I say demo 2 and I say publish. So this file will again get saved to that folder what I've created. Okay, so done. So this is how you can teach through your ebook also. Okay, if you want to switch between the screen also, that is also possible. So let me again demonstrate that part. So for the timing, let me just pause this video. Now when you want to demonstrate something, normally you will use the screen in the full screen mode. Okay, so you have to go for the settings over here, size of the screen, make it full screen, so that is better. Okay, and now you can switch between the windows. Okay, so right now this is the home screen of my laptop that I'm capturing. Then I can go to my web browser and I will say here I want to, let's say, demonstrate. So I will say record now. Okay, and I will say, okay, let the countdown finish. So I want to, let's say, how to add to PPT. Okay, so the video is by Ashish Onmani, and let's say I want to search on YouTube. Okay, so you can see, okay, this video has now appeared. I can start it, demo it, give a demo using that video file. Now I want to, let's say, go back to my PowerPoint presentation. So I will simply pause this video, minimize the screen. I will go to the PowerPoint presentation. Okay, I will demonstrate using the PowerPoint presentation. I will come back, I will go to the PDF file. Okay, I will teach through this PDF file. Okay, so it's not necessary that you only stick to only one kind of file, that means PowerPoint or a PDF or let's say a demo, online demo, etc. You can switch between the screens also. Only make sure that when you are switching between the screen, you keep your resolution in full screen mode. Okay, so let's say we now stop it. I say done. I will save. Okay, so here you can see that it has various things in it. Initially it was online demo, then there is a PowerPoint presentation over here, then there is a ebook demo over here. Okay, so I will simply say save video file. Okay, let's give a name, demo 3. Okay, so video is done. If you want, you can go back to your folder and you can check. So you have a demo 3 file over here that is ready. and this will have those three parts. Okay, we had a online demo, we had a PowerPoint, and we had a PDF file. Let's say, so this is the video. You can fast forward it. Demo it to station. Okay, I will demonstrate. Okay, end of five more online demo. Then you keep your resume save in a. So let me just close it. So this is how you can demonstrate through multiple things also. Many times what you want is to conduct a kind of a webinar where you want to speak and you want that the users should see you. Or when you are presenting, you should be able to show the presentation as well as your video. So that is also possible in Screencast-O-Matic. So launch the recorder. And now, instead of selecting the screen option, there are two other options available over here. One is webcam and second is both. So if you have a webcam installed with your laptop or your PC, then only you can use these options. So I will select webcam. So when you select webcam, okay, you can adjust your screen. You can see that now the webcam is capturing my image or my video. So whatever I speak, it can be recorded. So you just have to start recording. So when you say record, there will be a countdown. And whatever your webcam screen is captured and whatever you speak, that will be captured. Okay, and if you are happy with it, say done and save that file. For the timing, let me just delete it. So that is how you can use webcam. Okay, other option is you can use both screen as well as webcam. So if you select that, then what it will capture is your screen and a webcam is shown with a small part over here. You can see over here. Okay, so what I can do is I can start my PowerPoint presentation. Let me just do a full screen mode over here. And then when I say record, so it will record my PowerPoint presentation in the background and there will be my webcam in the corner over here. So my recording has started. Okay, I can go through my slides. So you can see the slides as well as the webcam screen over here. So it is kind of a live demo what I'm doing. Okay, and once you are done, you can stop it again, check the video. If you like it, save it. If not, then flush it out. Okay, so I will say done. I will say save. Okay, so that video, you can see it over here. My recording has started. Okay, I can go through my slides. You can see the slides as well as the webcam screen over here. So it is kind of a live demo what I'm doing. And once you are done, you can. So you can save this video. So I will give the name, say demo 4, and I will say publish. Only thing, when you do this kind of stuff, that means you are doing a screen as well as webcam. Okay, ensure that you are making a presentation in such a way that there will not get something that will get hidden behind the webcam screen. Okay, so you must have seen it, what has happened in my particular video, because this portion was getting hide between my webcam screen portion. Okay, so that care you will have to take. So I hope I have demonstrated almost all the different capabilities of Screencast-O-Matic. Now the question is, can you do all the stuff what I demonstrated together? That means, for initial part, can I do a screen capture? Then for the second half, can I do, let's say, the webcam? Then again, a combination of screen and webcam, and then again screen, like what I demonstrated in this video. The answer is no. Whatever the capturing mode you select, okay, that will be fixed for that particular video. That means if I select the screen capturing mode, then it will only capture the screen. If I select the webcam mode, it will only operate in webcam mode. Of course, you can pause it and then you can record it in chunks, but it will not switch between the modes that we are doing. Okay, for that you require some other stuff. Okay, for the timing I will not discuss it over here, otherwise the video will become too lengthy. Okay, after some time I may post that video also. Or else what you can do is there are some small tricks in the PowerPoint that you can use. Okay, PowerPoint actually allows you to insert audio, video as well as screen capturing. Okay, so one can even use that flexibility if you want to do it. Okay, but for the timing, let's keep the things simple. So use a screen customatic if you have a PowerPoint presentation, or if you have a, let's say, a ebook. Okay, and you want to teach something to the students, or you can even record your own video through the webcam where you want to express something and teach to the students. Okay, so thank you very much. I hope you have liked this video. If you have any queries, then of course there is a lot of material available on net. Okay, even on the screen customatic there are some demonstration videos available. You can also take help of those videos to learn more things about it. So thank you very much and take care.